All right, Shalom, Rastafari. This is something we want to go into, but we don't have much power on this battery right here. We're using the smartphone to record this, so bear with us on this, right? This is from, okay, this is the book of Methuselah, right? The book of Enoch. We read this before, and we did a little study on it, but we want to show why it's important for I and I to know I and I language. But the question we want to ask right here was Noah. Right, was Noah of the Bible, was Noah European? Well, of course people say no, Noah can be European. But what complexion was he? It's very clear that his complexion or his racial stock must have been different than what we normally would be considered and what normally is considered to be so. Now, this page right here, we saw something interesting here. And so, okay, here's this quote right here, the book of Methuselah. And it says, and after verse 106.1, and after those days, my son Methuselah chose a wife for his son Lamech, and she became pregnant by him and bore a son. Verse 2, it says, and his body was white like snow. Now, many times when white is translated, it's very interesting because it could mean clean. Not anything to do with white in the sense of Leviticus chapter 13, white, or the old time leprosy. So we have to be very careful about the translators. Remember, this is in translation. But we want y'all to know about this because it's the truth, right? And we need to get into it. So his body, it says, was white like snow and red like the flower of a rose. And the hair of his head was white. It says, like wool. And his eyes were beautiful, and when he opened his eyes, he made the whole house bright, right, like the sun. And so that the whole house was exceptionally bright, verse 3. And when he was taken from the hand of the midwife, he opened his mouth and spoke to the Lord of righteousness. And his father Lamech was afraid of him. His father Lamech was afraid of him. Kind of interesting right there, right? And fled and went to his father Methuselah. So they ask, so what do Afrocentrics, right? Afrocentrics have to say. The question I have for a lot of the Afrocentrics is that how many ancient African languages, how many Afro-Shemitics, Shemitic languages do these Afrocentrics know? Now, this is not to dismiss all the Afrocentrics. We know that a lot of important information has come out and continues to come out through the Afrocentric vein. You understand? But note this, the black, right, Ethiopian church or the Ethiopic church, it holds the book of Enoch or Hanok as canonical. So on this particular page, Egypt Forum, some of y'all might have seen this before. It claims that Noah was a white man. I think that's a little bit general. Remember, if it's an Ethiopic book, that means we're going to have to study it in the Ethiopic language. Otherwise, you are deep ending on translation. Now, one person said, oh, this is bullshit. For some reason, the name Enoch gives me the heebie-jeebies. I don't know what god or goddess you worship it. Now, others say that even Noah, this is what another Afrocentric here says, right? Someone named Khufu or Khufu, right? It says, either Noah was an albino or second, a peppermint candy, leaving the first one the only realistic possibility. And it says, BTW, since when white people had hair like wool? He says, man, you got to shake your head at some of the lame attempts that white Eurocentrics try to make. Okay, we could shake our head, but let's get to the root of it. Where the Afrocentrics stand up, let us go to the documentation and let us figure it out. We have gone to this documentation, but we want to put this out. Was Noah a white man? Was Noah a white man? And this is a point for the Afrocentrics. The only thing Afrocentrics can do is give sophistry. Most of them only sophistry arguments about it. There's a lot of, okay, melanin, we have melanin, but they don't know how to tap into the God, divine power of melanin because they still are outside of the covenant of the King of Kings and his Christ. Point blank, period. And many of them even slander the Father and Son, speaking about Ionized Rastafari, and speaking of the, they may accept Jesus or Yeshua as a black man, but they don't obey him. They prefer to obey white supremacy. If white supremacy says something, they obey it because they react. They're reactionary. You understand? So this is mainly for the so-called Afrocentrics, that we need to step up and become Afro-Shemitic. You know, so we can get into the detail of it. So the article down here is very, very good. It's an interesting back and forth. The ones are talking about albinism, so forth and so on. And this turns a lot of folks off of, you see, a lot of this turns a lot of folks off of Ethiopics, you understand, and because they don't even know the language. They are lost in mistranslation. So is this a mistranslation that Noah was a white man? I must admit, when I first came across the translation of that, I was like, what? So give thanks to God the Father and Yeshua in the name of Jesus, our black Lord and Savior, for sending I and I his Holy Spirit. You understand? That Holy Spirit gives us the gift of tongues so we can translate a lot of these tongues that we was not born speaking. You understand? But this page is interesting. It says, have any of you guys seen a newborn baby? You ever seen a newborn baby? Have you ever seen a newborn, African baby? A newborn African baby? And you notice this, the mother, the child. Now an idiot will say, oh, she must have been with a white guy. You understand? See, that's that Afro, that's part of the ignorance that ignorance has produced. You know what I'm saying? We are not promoting so-called just black racial supremacy. We're promoting God supremacy. And since God has taken on our humanity in his beloved Son, our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we're not all caught up on that anymore. We recognize what the truth is. We know that there's a spiritual reality behind all of these things. But the so-called Afrocentrics, boy, they don't really like that part of Enoch right there. This is why I wonder how come nobody was talking about this either. There was nobody mentioning anything about this mind. How come? Anyway, so his body was white like snow. Right? White like snow. Now notice the white in this context is not talking racially, but this is a translation. See, based on translation, because then when you go further down here, it talk about red like the flower of a rose, right? And then his hair of his head, it says right here, was white like wool. Notice these two whites right here. It's not talking about white in the sense of leprous or albinous. Notice it's not. It's not. And we have gone to the Ethiopic. You understand? We have gone to the Ethiopics. All you did was prove that whites are not normal humans. Now, see, it goes back and forth on a lot of this idiot stuff, right? Bloodless colored people. Then you get a lot of idiots, they're just talking, talking out of their own ignorance. And notice what will clarify this whole debate is to go to the language, the Ethiopic language. Unfortunately, many of the Ethiopians, some of them barely speak proper Amharic, much less Gutas, you understand, which is like saying, like comparing Italian to Latin. You understand? They don't study it. They turn their backs on it, trying to be like Negroes, living in the image of the so-called beast in this end of this Gentile world supremacy, this Gentile time. Right here is also interesting, you understand, as well. This is a very interesting chart right here that ones and ones put up. Give thanks. Right, give thanks. Look at some of the historical personages, right here as we go through this, right here, some of the historical personages. And you can see, some of the ancient people, the variety of black folks. Look at his peasy, his curly peasy beard. You don't see these guys wear that today. You understand? This also is a very good chart right here. Africans and the creation of writing, right? The creation of writing. Overstand the creation of writing. You see, it's all about the language. It's all about the linguistics. See, we're still living in that so-called curse of the Tower of Babel. Notice right here, the Jew, the captivity, the Jew of captivity. See his peasy head? Remember our mama would say, you better comb your peasy hair. Right? Don't walk around no peasy hair. So-called niggle snaps. He has some niggle snaps right there. You understand? Now, let's once again go to this. I know a lot of folks going to want to, you know, reason on this and go through this. And it is interesting. It is important. Unfortunately, been suppressed too long right there, right? So, I mean, this is albino. You can clearly see his hair. You understand? You can see that right there, right? You can see if these are also Africans. You understand? Also Africans, showing how the dominant gene, right, and the recessive gene. You understand? But there's a spiritual reality even in back of that. As well, you can see this right here. You understand, this black mother, or maybe it's her sister Karen, her brother right here. You understand? But yes, he also is African. You see, so y'all have to get out of that so-called hate, that racial hate that hate produced. And here you have a perfect example of the Esau and Jacob type, right? The Esau type, right? And the Jacob type. According to what the Bible and the Torah, you understand, the Orit, actually says, but the key once again is in our language. You understand? If we don't know our language, remember, how to make a slave was all about taking from us that knowledge of language, this ability to interpret, right? The ability to interpret. You understand? To go from low degrees, from ignorance, to high degrees, to overstanding. So the question is going to remain, was Noah, right, the Ark man, was the Ark man white? Was Noah a white man? You understand? It says that his body was white like snow, right, and red like the flower of a rose, and that they hear of what his what head, right, the hair of his head was white like wool. I'll give you a little hint. That word white for wool, we know what wool looks like, right? And who's wool? White like wool. The wool thing is a key right there. You understand? As well as that word white, we have to look at the proper context of it. Therefore, we have to get to the root of the matter. Why are we deep ending on translation only? Translation is good at first with King James Bible, but all praise and be to our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for giving us that gift of tongues. Not that gibberish that you're talking some of these so-called church. I'm talking about the real gift of tongues, like in the Bible, where they could communicate each one to their fellow lost sheep of the Beit Israel, whether he came from Ethiopia, whether he came from Syria, whether he came from Asia, whether he came from other parts of the world. You know, and they all could communicate as one. That's what that gift of tongues is all about. So Afrocentrics, the challenge to you is to grow up and to become an Afro-Shemitic. I know it's hard because you're all on that ham thing. You understand? You need to put down the pork. You understand? Put it down. All right. Shalom Ras Tefarit.